drop. You got the fire, they help me. Bringing that heat with the CD. When they see me, wanna be me. Better be me than me. We'll be right back.
So, even though it's freezing out there, we've still got loads of people braving the weather to watch this seasonal. I don't suppose that has anything to do with you, does it?
with you, you outshine in the mouth. Oh, you're so foxy, lady. Ride my mind, you drive me crazy. Not best, and I'm thinking that I can take you home.
Come here,
one
flower,
back
you, get your back up.
I wanna take you home.
Come here, one flower, back you, get your back up.
I could take you home.
Come here, one flower, back you, get your back up.
I could take you home.
This music change your mood.
Pull up, honk the horn. The party don't stop till the break of dawn. Flash light, rock the spot. The DJ playing, spinning all night.
Think I finally found the strength to fall in love. Dancing, sweating.
Down to earth with it. You so groovy, baby. And you feel me, baby.
Think I finally found the strength to fall in love. Dancing, sweating, feeling this club. Music bumping, girl, I feel the vibe. Keep it with me, girl, we bout to slide. All about to tell them, bring the ride.
Even though it's freezing out there, I'm pretty sure you'll have a lot of fun with this seasonal. Just make sure you wrap up warm.
Hello! I'm pleased to see you again, not merely for professional purposes, but also because of our developing social connection. Now, this is a BMW iSetter. For its size, it is deceptively powerful and also highly maneuverable, though I think perhaps not so maneuverable for the claimant who delivered theirs into the back of a furniture truck. So, if you would please test the iSetter's ability to navigate traffic whilst avoiding collisions. For the experiment and for your own safety, of course. So, if you would please test the iSetter's ability to navigate traffic whilst avoiding collisions. For the experiment and for your own safety, of course. And so the claim is disproved. With sufficient driver application, the BMW iSetter may navigate even dense traffic. I will inform the claimant that they must simply try harder. Our next case involves an outlandish claim and a vehicle with something of a reputation here in Britain, which I believe to be undeserved. You know this, the Reliant Supervan. With some small stability enhancements, this design, in my opinion, is quite sound.
You will proceed, please, to Bamborough Castle, where we will attempt a small and highly scientific jump.
In 400 meters, turn left. Turn left.
Ah, you see? My enhancements greatly improve stability with no detriment to the look of the car. If anything, a small improvement, I think.
200 meters, you will arrive at your destination.
Good, good. Now, to recreate the conditions of the accident which resulted in a claim for damages to a church roof.
You see, the fiberglass construction makes the Reliance Supervan light enough to become airborne. It lacks, I think, in aerodynamics and engine power. For this next test, I have compensated, perhaps overcompensated. We shall see.
It occurs to me that I have added no additional safety features, but at least you will be landing on sand. It worked. I mean, of course it worked. And so we see that it is entirely possible to deposit a Reliance Superfan in the belfry of a country church. I will contact the claimant and pass on the good news. Well, the results anyway.
Do you know that in my spare time I am an avid watcher of films? Oh yes, one of my favorite films sees young people having personal revelations whilst racing classic cars. See if you can tell what it is. Now, one of my claimants has apparently tried to recreate scenes of the film, which features a Morris Minor similar to this one, with limited success.
They will require city conditions and traffic lights. So, Edinburgh, if you please.
In 400 meters, turn left. Turn left.
tomorrow is not so much like the California of the film, but perhaps we can use our imaginations. Well done, you have achieved the optimal result for the first part of our test, which is, I'm not so sure, this is a uniquely American word, but cruising, I think, yes?
Now we must test the drag race performance of the Morris Minor with a few small engine modifications of my own. This is not strictly reproducing conditions of the film, but nor is the speed trap we are borrowing from the Horizon Festival.
Now, straight line speed is our object. If it helps, you may imagine you are racing against an impossibly handsome actor. Excellent. I will advise the claimants that they may be confident lining up against an Austin Healey sprite, as in the film. Once their Morris Minor returns from the crash repairer, of course.
I must confess, I was confused by our next case involving a racing truck. I was not aware of such a term. I had to consult with Horizon to find a suitable test vehicle. Though I was not disappointed with the result. Perhaps before we begin testing, you would like a chance to, how do you say, get a feel for this machine?
In 100 meters, turn right. Turn right. Turn right. In 400 meters, turn left. Turn left. Still too soon for me. In 400 meters, turn right. Turn right. Good. Unlike our claimant, you have passed the first test. The vehicle is not upside down.
Our claimant insists that these so-called high-performance heavy vehicles are simply too fast to manage variable terrain. We will attempt not only to prove otherwise, but to demonstrate they are much faster when kept firmly on the road.
You may feel an urge to go off-road. Despite my carefully plotted route, you will please resist this urge. Much improved acceleration over flat ground. Enhanced traction through tight corners, yes. Also, I must congratulate you on your restraint. Downhill roads provide increased downforce as well as speed. Interesting. You see, we may dispute the claim that the racing truck cannot be controlled. Indeed, if yours was refrigerated, you could quite easily deliver milk or eggs or other perishable goods.